r/AskReddit. What was your I don't get paid enough for this moment at work? Worked at a fast food place about 13 years ago. This lady in the drive-thru claimed she was missing a sandwich. Our policy was to ask for the bags back to verify. I asked to see the bags, 3 or 4. Decent sized order, and instead of handing them back like a civilized human being, she instantly started raging and throwing the food into the window while cussing me out. Guess what one of the items that she threw at me was? Yep. Said missing sandwich. Shitty people will always try to scam something. Well, over 2 decades ago, I fielded a call from somebody insisting they were missing an entire 10 pack of tacos on their 20 taco order. I had no problem telling them I had been making food all day and no, an order like that had never come up on my screen, and to try scamming some other restaurant. I walked into the bathroom, and someone had smeared poop on literally every single surface, wall, everything except one small part of the ceiling they couldn't reach. Percasso almost made me quit, but luckily my boss told me to lock it, not let anyone else use it, and he got someone to come with a pressure washer. Props to your boss, honestly. Best boss on the thread, as far as I can tell. My boss insisted that everybody be at their desks at 8:30 sharp. She made me take roll on an attendance sheet and hand it into her every day. She also made me do it at lunchtime, when everybody left and came back, and when they left at night. Took roll for a bunch of adults 3 times a day. I don't work there anymore. Our productivity and morale was through the roof with the old boss. He got promoted to corporate and company hired a new one. He goes through every single room at 8 o'clock sharp to check if people are working and if the guys that work outside the office already left. Same thing after lunch. Everyone is ducking miserable and performance went downhill. Posted before this before. This was back in the late 90s. I was working at Walmart as my first job as a teenager. I was floated to the garden department one day and there was a guy looking at lawn fertilizer. I walked over and asked if he needs help. He said not now. Just looking at the different kinds you have. Pretty standard reply from the guy. So I said okay. Let me know. I walk away. And then swing back about 5 minutes later. Same guy has proceeded to rip open about 10 different kinds of the fertilizer all over the ground and is rolling around in the stuff. He is also taste sampling the stuff. I called my manager because I did not want to deal with it. Security escorted the guy out the store and called an ambulance in case the ingestion of the fertilizer hurt him. Was the customer a dog? The time I went to sleep under my desk at work at 5 a.m. because I needed to be back at my desk for an 8 a.m. call. I had promised myself a long time ago that I would never sleep under my desk. I would go home. Or just work straight through. But I wouldn't do that. I only lived a 12-minute walk home. But that night I realized that getting those extra 24 minutes of sleep were worth not going home. I was so sad about it. I am a corporate lawyer. We had been working literally around the clock for days on a deal that was going sideways. This was a Wednesday, a Thursday morning. But I had been there until 3 a.m. Sunday night, 5 a.m. Monday night, 6 a.m. Tuesday night, and had been back in the office by 9 a.m. every day. That's when I knew I needed to quit. But I'm still here a year and change later. Oops. That schedule sounds crazy. Do you still work those insane hours now? That was among the absolute worst of it. After back-to-back 120-hour weeks, you really start to lose your mind. No idea how anyone expects you to be doing high-level legal work on this little sleep. I was being billed out at close to $1,000 hour but was probably drooling on myself for parts of those weeks. I've since moved to a different group within the same firm. And it's saner. Or at least there tend to not be as many bad weeks in a row. I work in childcare. There was one time we had one kid who had a diaper blowout and one kid who puked everywhere. There's only 2 teachers, so one has to handle the blowout and one the vomit, while also keeping the rest of the kids away from it all. I don't think you understand what a contract means. Besides, this is an opportunity for you. Semicolon, when the new manager tried to move me to night shifts weekend from my day shifts working days despite my contract being very specific about when I worked. Hey, you were right. This is a big opportunity for me, was how I opened when I told her I was quitting. The look of shock and 15 minutes of silence on her part were hilarious and the best feeling interval of my entire life when she realized I had thrown her own stupid words back at her. I was working late, like 2 a.m. in the office. My manager said, "Let's go to the convenience store to buy some snacks and smokes." She sits in the back and we drive there. After we get our shit, she says, "Can we swing by this street intersection real quick?" When we get to that intersection, I guess she sees a car that belongs to someone she knows, parked in front of her boyfriend's house. She starts to wail, cry and kick around in the back seat, while my bewildered ass just holds the steering wheel, with a stupid look on my face. After 20 minutes of that shit, we drive back to the office. I drop her off and I go home. WTF. Used to work as a dental nurse. First patient of the friggin' day. Bloke said he felt sick after having a local anesthetic. He looked it. I grabbed the bin and told him if he needed to vomit, take the bin. He held it in his lap and turned, vomiting down the side of the chair and all over my pants and shoes. Of course I had to clean it up and of course they wouldn't let me go home to change. Working at Target on Black Friday in the back room without anyone else to help me pull the product and getting told I am not keeping up. Weird how I got sick 2 hours into my volunteered 12-8 shift. Whoa, volunteering? Hell yeah. My buddy worked security and needed a ride so I figured I'd just offer to work his hours and crash at his place after to save myself a long drive. We got dinner before going in and planned to get breakfast after. We did it every year since we worked the night of Black Friday as well. I still crashed at his place and picked him up. I wasn't gonna screw him over. Having to listen to a child scream his head off because the father insisted on injection instead of the calming drug we usually use for kids that small. A-hole father. That kid is going to be scared of the dentist for a long time, if not for life. As an adult, can I request that calming drug for myself? In Sweden you can, depending on the procedure. It's not very common though, but for people with extreme fear we still do use it before some procedures. I work in security, and a bit under a year ago, I worked at some kind of public TV event. My job was to keep people without passes out of a specific area which was intended for those working behind the scenes to kick back and relax and get their lunches and all that. Anyway, only ones I was allowed entrance were people with passes and other security folks. But then word from above came that the exception was to be made for some kind of supposedly famous child music group. I had no clue what they looked like. So 4 kids and their parents walk up and I stop them. "Don't you know WHO?" These are quickly followed. Eventually it got cleared up. And every time after they kept bringing in more friends and family members and the same song and dance continued. You. Doing landscaping during the summers while in college. I rolled up a long piece of sod I had just cut and placed it in a wheelbarrow. When I turned back around, there's a copperhead sitting in the wheelbarrow giving me the stank eye. Apparently I had rolled a copperhead up in the sod and carried it to the wheelbarrow before he was able to get out. I ended up having to kill 4 copperheads that day. Was working the registers at a grocery store. About an hour before closing, a customer comes to my lane with 2 48-cl egg cartons. Stumbles a bit putting them onto the belt. And before I can react the entire thing was on the ground. Best part? Apparently the janitor had left already. So I got to spend the next hour cleaning up 96 broken eggs with nothing but paper towels. My mother was moving into state with my father and it was the last time I'd see either of my parents for months. I was 18 and just graduated school. I explained this to my boss but he just said I would have to see her another time because he needed a fence put up over the weekend. I told him I was leaving either way and he could put his own fence up. I quit soon after that. He also accused me of lying and berated me multiple times for random things that I either didn't do and refusing to pay me 4 weeks at a time. When I worked at McDonald's, I found out we didn't get paid for closing. We got paid until the store closed. So if it took us an extra hour or two to close, that wasn't paid. I wish I knew what I know now, because that is an open and shut case. But at the time, I was young and dumb. My first paycheck, I noticed I had a ton of missing hours. So when I asked my boss about it, she told me we only get paid until the store closed. So that night, I walked out when the store closed. They tried to guilt me into staying, because the other team members need me duck. That, I don't work for free, sorry, especially when I'm already making minimum wage. No thanks, not gonna happen. A similar thing happened to me when I worked at a Taco Bell when I was a teenager. During the first closing shift I was scheduled for after I was done cleaning everything, I told the manager I was ready to clock out and go home. She told me she still had at least an hour of paperwork left to do and needed me to stay while she did it since there was a rule that no one could be in the store alone, but she told me to clock out. I laughed in her face and told her, "I clock out, I leave." She didn't make me clock out and never scheduled me to close again, so win-win for me. When a clarinet came across my bench that someone had jizzed in. When I found a dead mouse in a Bari Sacks. When people think duct tape or superglue is an acceptable substitute for soldering parts together. When people use superglue on their instruments. Period. I was being sent all over the province to give leaflets to people. We're talking about an average of 4 hours of travel and 3 or 4 different bus and trains per day to get there and back home. I tried to tell my boss if they could just tell me where I wasn't supposed to go because we'd already left leaflets there. But they insisted I just kept going to that specific part of the province. And said that they were going to keep sending me there and further north. Which meant that I was gonna spend even more time per day traveling. To walk for hours and hours for €300.50 per correctly delivered leaflet. I called them and said, "Look, this isn't gonna cut it. I'm not gonna waste your time. I quit." They told me, "Well, you're gonna travel 4 hours anyway," but I quit nonetheless. I now travel a grand total of 20 minutes of trains per day. Who's traveling 4 hours now, suckers? I have to render at least 3 hours of OT to get everything done within the deadline, and we get no OT or holiday pay. I know different workplaces are different, but my attitude has always been if I need to work and paid to meet a deadline, then that deadline doesn't get met. I would have to be working in something genuinely important to voluntarily give up my time for free. When I walked into the room of a confused patient on blood thinners who had ripped out his IV and catheter, and had shit and blood on every surface of his room. It looked like a murder had been committed. I've been through a lot as a nurse, but that was like going into a war zone. Weird one. And not horrible, but made me just want to go duck and puke. I was the cashier. Old guy, probably a doctor, snaps at me when I happily share the amount he owes. He fiddles with his cards, then cash, the cards. The finally hands me 2 20s, $16.83 change. Fine. I count it out and hand it to him gently so as not to drop the cash. Change and the receipt. After, he stands there and says, "I want to ask you a question. Do they train you to handle change that way?" I'd handed him the bills, receipt, then change all the while making sure he had it in hand properly and politely. I said, "I never even thought of it before. It's pretty much common courtesy." He said, "Well, in my logical mind, it's change first, then bills, then receipt, you know, the weight of it." I said, "Cool, I'm mindful of that. Good idea." He then wants to shake my hand. He gives me the death grip. Squeezing like a mother ducker, I reciprocate. Nicely. Pop goes his pinky knuckle. He lets go mortified and marches out of the store. I think I broke a doctor's pinky knuckle and now I'm wondering if I or the store, or both will get sued. I work from home as a freelance content writer and it's a pretty relaxing gig most of the time. But, every now and then, I get a client that will constantly bug me for updates 2 to 3 times a day. I usually drop the contract when they get on my nerves, since they're not worth the stress and anxiety. An old job, they decided to decrease hours but keep the 2-for-1 burger pizza deal on, meaning I'd spend 12 hours in a basement kitchen by myself trying to cook burgers, roll out pizza doughs and do the KP work at the same time. When I was told I needed to be nice and stop causing problems because I had reported a new employee, who happened to be friends with the boss, for racism against our Hispanic employees, I could forget all the sexual assault, the literally having another employee bite my ass, the antisemitism toward me, but I will not put up with some guy coming in and being racist to the people I work with. When I was working as a cashier at Borders, I threw my back out one day. I was in a lot of pain and there was only one position I could be in that didn't cause me pain. I had been working there for like 5 months at that point and had never taken a day off. So I figured it was about time and I called in to let them know I wouldn't be coming in the next day because I hurt my back and I was going see a doctor. My manager's response was, "Can't you just take a couple of Tylenol and come in anyway? We need you." Duck that. I was not going to come in and be miserable in pain at that job. So I said no and reminded her it was my first day off. Her response to that was that she was disappointed because she thought I was a team player. Having to work a 12-hour overnight shift on a Friday in addition to working my full week of hours. This happened for a whole month BC. My company at the time didn't see hiring someone for that shift as a priority. I was a manager of a remote location. My former boss is a dong. Hence why former. When I was 15 and working at McDonald's, someone dropped their colostomy bag in the bathroom, causing what can only be described as a massive shit explosion. Guess who got paid $6 an hour to clean that up? It was on the ducking ceiling. IT was everywhere. Working retail at a smaller hardware store, my boss called me on my first weekend off in 3 months to ask me how to process a transaction because he had no idea. Wanted me to walk him through it over the phone while the customer was waiting. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.